possibly allowing us to invent new speedrunning strategies with the newfound knowledge. However, with the code effectively locked up, we can only sit and imagine what secrets may lie within. Similar to the boss skip theories mentioned before, Early Girlfriend describes the theory that Red Ball could somehow clip or break open the cage that Pink Ball is lowered down in earlier than intended, creating the potential for a massive time save. The level ends when Red Ball makes contact with Pink Ball, a possibility that is separated by just a thin chip of metal. Deng Shibara is currently the world record holder for the slowest time on the Red Ball 3 leaderboards. All of their speedruns on speedrun.com were performed in around a 4-month time period from late 2015 to early 2016, with no apparent activity being recorded since then. Their blazing fast Red Ball 3 time of 45:36 actually used to be the world record due to no other runs being present on the leaderboards. The description of this run reads, "Pretty good run, will be hard to improve." The world record as of recording this video is a 5:36, exactly 40 minutes faster than this run, a run which, once again, used to be the world record. Truman to Good is a speedrun.com user that never submitted any runs, but still managed to change the course of history of Red Ball speedrunning with just one guide on the 17th of October, 2017. It reads, "If you pause and jump while on the ground, your game will be paused, but when you click to pee again, you will jump. Knowing this, if you press P and jump at the same time, then hold space and click P, you jump twice as high. I found this messing around, so this should make the run a lot easier." That's right, this random person who created a speedrun.com account presumably just to make this post, discovered pause jumping, the most important speedrunning glitch present in both Red Ball 2 and Red Ball 3. This post actually went unnoticed for quite a while, as Red Ball 3 was extremely inactive at the time, and because guideposts are far less likely to be seen than forum posts. It was only after Motor Jam noticed the post that I used it to beat Jandog with a 6:38 on the 17th of October, 2018, exactly a year after the trick was initially discovered. On the same day, I achieved a 13:52 with the glitch in Red Ball 2. In Volume 4 of Red Ball 4 Mobile, the second phase of the boss had a massive change with the updated release on July 8, 2020. A once difficult moving laser section was trimmed down to just a short squeeze, reducing both the difficulty and length of the boss. Though it could have been removed because of the moderate difficulty, it is still completely unknown exactly why the change was made. For all we know, it could have been a complete mistake. The patch notes for that July 8th update only mentions bug fixes, saying nothing about the substantial change to the boss. And there you have it, the Red Ball speedrunning iceberg fully explained. Common knowledge to theoretical pipe dreams, this two-part series has revealed a great deal about the Red Ball series and the secrets that lie within. While this iceberg is by no means a fully comprehensive knowledge base of the Red Ball speedrunning community, it still holds a massive wealth of knowledge, with it still having many holes that we can hope to fill in one day. I thank you for watching to the end of the video, and I encourage you to check out some of the other Flash and Red Ball related content present on my channel, if this was of any interest to you. Also, consider following me on Twitch and joining my Discord server. Both are linked in the description.